went with Josh?
Well, first of all, I think it's clear, at least to me, he went with Josh because he likes Josh. Are they buddies? I mean, he even said, I like him as a guy. Like, a lot of this was, that's my guy. I'm hoping he does it. And I will say this, Coach, if they're that close, and Josh doesn't always listen to Tom, right? That we've seen that on their interviews. Josh should be picking his brain about 12 personnel, right? That was huge for New England with Gronkowski and Aaron Hernandez. And they got two talented tight ends in Buffalo. Obviously, your receiving core is in flux, at least right now. They should be running that a lot, and I think he should be picking Brady's brain on that. But I am, from a football perspective, Coach, I'm very surprised because, obviously, the offseason that the Bills have had, I think this is, at least to date, we'll see what they do in the draft and other moves, but to date, this is, I think, the worst team they've gone into the season with in the last 3 or 4 years. All right, you lost your two best receivers. You lost 5 of your 8 captains. Defensively, you lost some, you know, critical pieces. I think they'll be good defensively because McDermott is good on that side of the ball. And last year, despite a lot of injuries, they were good defensively. But still, I mean, saying that, unless you are saying Mahomes is going to win it this year and then next year maybe Josh can come back, I would put these quarterbacks ahead of Allen as far as winning their first Super Bowl before him right now. Lamar, Burrow, C.J. Stroud, I'm not saying he's going to win it this year, but right now I'd put him ahead of Allen because of the team. And then on the NFC side, just because of the team is great, Purdy.
Correct.
Jordan Love, Jared Goff, and maybe Jalen Hurts. I'm just saying ahead of Josh Allen now because of the team. So
tough one for Dak. Yeah. Tough list for Dak.
Yeah, Dak. I got another list Dak will be on, but not this one. But yeah, Coach. So football, from a football sense, I'm very surprised.
It's funny you said Tom, whether or not Tom likes Josh, because that's the first thing I looked up. Does Tom Brady golf with Josh?
Yes.
And he does. And they're buddies. And that's exactly what this felt like. It's like, okay, I'm going to go with my buddy. And when you look at it, you know, Josh has to get over the 18 interceptions. That's a problem. They get rid of Diggs. And whenever you get rid of a player and you're going to pay him $3 million more on the cap than you would if you had him, obviously that's a problem. So now the chemistry gets better in the building, but you can't replace that talent that he brought on Sunday. Then he loses 4 out of his 5 receivers. So from a force multiplier perspective, this is the big test for him, whether or not he can elevate the offense, losing his best weapon, losing all that continuity, and it's a big if.
I really hate this whole idea that this is what Josh Allen has to prove to be able to do to elevate the offense. He's been elevating the offense and carrying the Bills from day one. And the revolving door with OCs, like, he's already had to overcome and bring up the team as much as possible, way more than Jalen Hurts, Brock Purdy, Patrick Mahomes, Joe Burrow, any of the other quarterbacks that were on that list. So this idea is, I really, really reject this wholeheartedly. You know, I'm not saying that I think Josh Allen will be the next quarterback to win a Super Bowl, but that's not because I believe Josh Allen is incapable of doing so. If you put Josh Allen on the Eagles in 2023, whatever that the year ends up being, they win a Super Bowl. If you put Josh Allen on any of the years that the Chiefs won the Super Bowl, Josh Allen wins a Super Bowl. You put Josh Allen on the 49ers last season, they win a Super Bowl. So, because he could just do more. He's more versatile. Not only does he have a cannon and he can throw, but then he is a physical beast. I mean, he is an animal. I think what it is a lot of people don't watch these other games. They don't watch Josh Allen play, which I understand. You know, it seems like you have two types of fans, and I seem to interact with both of them in a lot of ways, honestly. You have fans that either watch all the games or the games that they kind of have access to because, you know, the NFL can be tough like that, or they're really just watching their own team. I watch pretty much all the games that I can, and then I even, you know, watch the games that are more difficult to find through the, you know, the various means that you can go do that. And especially if it's going to be like an interesting matchup, like, you know, Josh Allen versus, I don't know, whoever. And, but the game looks like it should be an interesting game, and it's, but it's not like a Sunday night game or whatever. Like, I'll go make sure I watch it. So I understand that if you just look at some of the stats of Josh Allen and the interceptions, and you can make those easy statements of like, oh, he's not accurate or this or that, he's careless with the ball. And it's a fair criticism to a degree. But the Dolphins game last season is the perfect example. A perfect example. Go back and watch that game. Just watch, you know, watch like the extended highlights, okay? It is the perfect example of not only how the Bills have relied on Josh Allen and what Josh Allen has to do to win games. They have to live and die by him. And that some of his interceptions are because it's just like he has to make something happen, because if he can't, then they're not going to win. Or it's, for, you know, like two of those interceptions, I don't remember exactly, but one of them was definitely a fourth down, and it was just like he had to just throw up a prayer. So the interception didn't matter. The interception actually hurt the Dolphins. They would have been better off catching it and then just dropping it, you know, but they didn't. And then another play was, again, it was essentially like just another prayer that you're just kind of throwing up. And then, yes, he did have a terrible interception where it was like, ooh, you can't make that throw. But that's the problem. Every quarterback has those interceptions. So even some of his interceptions, I think, are misleading. But then again, some of the other things that he has to do, like that huge run that he took off against the Dolphins to get that first down that, you know, really iced the game. I mean, like, it was really all him as to why they even got that win in the first place. And then people love to point and say, yeah, well, if he didn't throw those interceptions, then he wouldn't have needed to do those heroics. And it's like, that's not really accurate either, because you're acting like if he was just a more conservative, traditional, weaker quarterback, that like everything would just be all great and dandy. And it's just not true. This is what happens when you are an athletic freak like Josh Allen. And it was the same thing with Lamar, Josh Allen, with Lamar Jackson and even Cam Newton and that. It's just when you have these physical freak quarterbacks, you just rely on them to be physical freaks. And then it catches up with you. And the reality is that Josh has not had true stability since they have a defensive head coach. Every time he gets a new OC, it's essentially like having a new head coach for the offense. You know, that's really what it ends up coming down to. So it's like Josh Allen has already had like three or four head coaches. If Patrick Mahomes kept having a different head coach every year or two, people would be losing their mind. You know, that's why people give the benefit of the doubt to even Baker Mayfield, because he's had so many different, you know, coaches. You know, we give those quarterbacks grace in that regard, but not when they keep getting a different OC. And that's really what it is. When you have a defensive head coach and you keep getting a new OC, that's what it is. And I always point to this. When he had a competent, true, blue-blooded OC in Dable, he played amazing. It really, really matters. I mean, it just matters. How often they call on Josh to, you know, sacrifice his body and to just push it is unbelievable. And then, you know, again, it wasn't Troy Aikman, I think it was Collinsworth, who said, like, you know, this team just, you know, is like Brett Favre. You know, they just know that the way they're going to win is by Josh just throwing and just taking chance after chance after chance. And they're either going to, you know, win, or he's going to throw a boatload of interceptions. And that is what the team relies on. That is not Josh Allen's fault. That is the design of the Buffalo Bills. So I take issue when all that blame gets dropped on Josh Allen, because I just don't believe that it's on him. So to say that he needs to now show more than what he's already done, I just think is not really fair. And I know a couple people really believe in their new OC right now. And I don't have strong feelings either way, quite honestly. I know he seemingly righted the ship last season for the second half of the season, but I like to see a little more personally before I start saying, okay, he's good, everything's all good. But yeah, I mean, I think Josh Allen is definitely in a more difficult situation than a lot of these other quarterbacks that, you know, that they just listed, you know, whether it be Jordan Love, Jalen Hurts, you know, I'm not going to name all the other quarterbacks again, but I see that being, you know, it's more of a, of an organization and a team-based problem. Because, again, I mean, it's like, God, Matt LaFleur is a great offensive mind. Shanahan is obviously a great offensive mind. It's like, you know, of course those quarterbacks are going to be in a better position to succeed. And yeah, I just think it's interesting to see so much of the hate get thrown Josh Allen's way. And that's not Brew or Mangini up here. I'm now basing more off of fans and specifically the people that comment on this channel. And I think because it's so many people are Patrick Mahomes fans, you know, and I get it. You're a huge Patrick Mahomes fan. I love Mahomes too. But it's just, you see Josh Allen as like, you know, the enemy for some reason. And I mean, I don't even want to say for some reason, I guess for technically good reason, but I would really, you know, if anything, you should want Josh Allen to be great, because then that makes Patrick Mahomes look even better. But you guys want to keep saying that Josh Allen is trash, not that good. If that's the case, then it's not that impressive that Josh Allen, that Patrick Mahomes beats him. So it's like, which way do you want it? Do you want to tell me that Patrick Mahomes is the best quarterback ever and he's unbelievable and Josh Allen can't beat him? Because that's impressive if Josh Allen is an amazing quarterback, you know, a future Hall of Famer. If Josh Allen is a scrub and not that good, well then, okay, so Patrick Mahomes is beating up on bad quarterbacks. Why is that impressive? So, you know, you guys decide. Do you want Josh Allen to be good or not? But those are just my thoughts. I would absolutely love to hear yours. Are you surprised that Tom Brady picked Josh Allen? Or do you think it was just him, you know, being buddy-buddy with Allen? I would absolutely love to hear your thoughts, whether you agree with me or disagree with me. I read every single comment. So let's get in some discussions. Let's get in some fights. But ultimately, let's just have some fun. And please do consider subscribing. We are building an amazing community here, and I would absolutely love to see you part of it. I want to build something that we all genuinely feel connected to, something that we're really excited to be part of, and I think we're well on our way to doing it. And please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, as it really does help with the visibility and the algorithm, and it helps combat the haters and the trolls. Thank you so much, and see you next time.